Java provides you with a wide variety of primitives for your applications. But look around you. You see people, cars, houses, books. You don't see too many numbers or characters walking around. We need some way to represent real-world objects or concepts. In Java, you can create your own types to model any concept your program needs. These models are called classes. In this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to create a class in Java. Before we start into how to create a class in Java, I have a question for you, my audience. I'm curious, what videos are you watching besides this one? Are they all programming videos, gaming videos? What are your favorite videos to watch? Let me know by leaving comments down below. We're going to look at what problem classes solve. Then we'll talk about what is a class and what makes a good class in a Java program. We'll finish up with the syntax for creating a class in Java. What problem are we trying to solve with classes? With Java primitives, we have characters, booleans, integers, and floating point numbers. We need a duck. We could, in theory, stamp every duck in existence with an integer, but then how would we know that that duck, 2023, is a female Mandarin duck in India? There are all kinds of schemes we could cook up to store ducks in a number, but eventually they're going to fall apart. We saw a bit of this problem when we talked about arrays. With arrays, we avoided sorting temperature ranges into 36 variables by using three arrays. Arrays are one type of class in Java. The purpose of an array class is to store a list of ordered values. What I didn't show you was that arrays also have behavior, and in Java, arrays are a special type of class. We'll cover that very soon. A Java class is an abstraction we use to represent a real-world object or concept. When you're thinking of things you might want to model as a class, think of nouns. Your attributes are adjectives, and your behavior are verbs. It's a bit simplistic, but this is a good place to start. For your class, you need to answer who, what, where, why, when, and how. Who is calling the class? What does the class do? Where in your application does it do what it needs to do? Why is this class handling this task? And finally, when is it to do what it's supposed to do? And how? Well, that's your code. Classes act as blueprints for our models in Java. The blueprint is used to create a class in Java. In the blueprint, you specify all the attributes and behavior your real-world object needs to be created. In creating a duck, we specify attributes like species name, weight, age, sex, and color. The behavior would be things like swim, eat, and quack. These birds could be represented with a single class. They're all examples from the kind of class bird. To say it another way, the class describes the kind of object we're talking about. The class we'd define would contain attributes that are common to each of these birds. The best classes model single-purpose concepts. That means it does one job. The reason you want to do this is if you create a class that does 100 things, you're going to need to change it a lot. If it does one thing, you're less likely to need to change the class. Every time you make a change to a class, you're introducing the possibility of breaking the class. Breaking working code is bad. Here's a good example. A security class to authenticate and authorize users. Its one task is to handle security in your entire application. This way, if your class for application security changes, you're changing this one class. It also makes it easy to replace if you need to use a new class for security. On the other hand, if you need to change how you render graphics in your application, you don't want to touch the security code. 3 in the morning phone calls because your users can't log into your application are no fun. When you're thinking of what would make a good class, try to keep your model simple. I had a professor who always said, horses aren't stupid. They're as smart as they need to be a horse. Your classes should be the same way. Just focus on what they need to accomplish and nothing more. If you need a car, don't bother trying to model the engine inside the car if you're never going to use it. That doesn't mean your class can't be responsible for the behavior of other classes. For example, you might have a class representing a glowing power gem in a game. That gem could be in a box, so the magic gem is one class and the box is a second class. A class can be an attribute for another class. Let's try creating a class in Java. We said we needed a duck, so let's create a Java class that represents a duck. We're not going to define attributes or behavior yet. We'll look for that in depth in another lesson. For now, I just want to show you the basics for creating a new type in Java. When you create a class in Java, you're creating a new file. Every class that is available to your application must be in its own file. The file has the same name as your class. If your class is called duck, then it exists in a file called duck.java. That's why I said it was important that the name matched the file when we worked in the Hello World application. Okay, like I said earlier, to create a new class in Java, you're creating a file with the class name as the name of that file. Now you can create it using your favorite text editor. I'm going to go ahead and do this in NetBeans. So hit File, New File. For the category, we want Java. For the file type, we want Java class. Next, we'll call it duck. We'll leave the package empty for now. I'll cover packages in a later lesson. And we hit finish. And we've created our class called duck. It starts with public, class, and then the name of our class, which in this case is called duck. It's also in a file duck.java. And with that, we've created a Java class that we can use in our application. Okay, we now know what makes a good class. We also know how to create a class in Java. If you have any questions about how to create a class in Java, please leave them in the comments below. In the next video, we'll look at using our Java classes in our applications by turning our type blueprints into actual values. Till then. Hey, thanks for watching the video. There's a quick quiz for this on dgu.com if you'd like to gauge how much you learned. If you like the videos you're seeing, please let me know by liking the video and hitting the subscribe button for the DGU channel on YouTube. I'd really appreciate that. If you have concerns or questions, please leave them in the comments below or on dgu.com. There's a poll on the front page of dgu.com, so you can also let me know what topic gets covered next. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.